Hello everyone, myself Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand Stop Technology Solapur. Today we are dealing with the chapter or the bit differential gearbox. So under this bit, the learning outcome is at the end of this session, student will able to calculate speed ratio of the differential gearbox. So this is a diagram, schematic diagram of the differential gearbox. So we will discuss how the differential gearbox will work. Before that, so the differential gearbox is used for giving or transmitting the motion from engine to the rear axle. This is the first application, and the second and very important application of this differential gearbox is to vary the speed from inner wheel and the outer wheel. Means suppose the speed of the inner wheel, if you are taking a turn, the speed of the inner wheel should be the less than that of the outer wheel, because the inner wheel will get lesser space or lesser distance than that of the outer wheel. The outer wheel covers the maximum distance if it is taking in this direction. So there is a speed variation in this two wheel that can be achieved by using the differential gearbox. So the construction of this differential gearbox is, before that, what is the application of the differential gearbox? So you can think about this. This is very simple. In automobile, the differential gearbox is used because if you are taking a turn, your the outer wheel takes more radius or the distance than that of the inner wheels. At that time, we required the speed variation between the two wheel, that is the inner wheel and the outer wheel, that can be achieved by using the differential gearbox. So we will see the construction of this differential gearbox. This is a propeller shaft A which is connected to the engine. From the engine, the propeller shaft is going to rotate. So from the propeller shaft, the bevel gear A is mounted on the propeller shaft, which is keyed. Then A, from the bevel gear A, it is transmitted to the bevel gear B. Then the B is connected by the arms. As the B will get rotated, the arm will get rotated. So if suppose we are moving on a straight path, at that time this whole unit acts as only the single, because if the motion is transmitted from this to this, there is no resistance occurs to the any of the wheel. That's why the complete this spindle will not get rotated by its own. Because of that, we are getting the straight line motion, and the unit is considered as a whole single unit. That's why the speed of the wheel, these two wheels, we can call this wheel P and this wheel Q. These two wheel P and Q rotates with the same speed on the straight path. So next, this is a arms. The arms and the gear E are connected by this spindle. Gear C is mesh with the gear D. Gear C mesh with the gear E. Gear E mesh with the gear D. The number of teeth on the gear C and D are the same, as well as the number of teeth on the E and F are the same. So if you are taking a turn, left or right turn, at that time, if you are taking the turns in this direction, at that time the resistance is occurs to this wheel P. So as the resistance is occurs to this wheel P, well, this is connected to this shaft P, and the shaft P is keyed to this gear C. So at that time the spindle will revolve about its own axis, so that we are getting the different speed for the C and this gear D. So the gears, the speed of the gear C is different and the gear speed of the gear D is different. As the rotation, this rotates, if we are taking in this turn, the speed of this is increases and the speed of this wheel P is decreases, increases and decreases. So this will take the more turn, like this construction is there. So we should know how to calculate the speed or the speed ratio of this differential gearbox, or the speed of every element used in the differential gearbox. So already we have seen in case of the epicyclic gear train what is meant by this table formulation. So same thing is there. So in this case, the gear B is fixed gear fixed. Gear B, so this gear B is fixed, and gear C rotates through the plus one revolution. This gear C rotates with the plus one revolution. That's why gear B is fixed. Gear C makes the plus one revolution. So we have to find out the speed of the E. Now we are knowing the C and E are externally matched by the bevel gear. So we are knowing an E by and C is inversely proportional to the number of TC by T. Therefore, as the NC is equal to 1, we are getting an E is equal to TC by TE. Therefore, we are getting TC by TE. As both are rotated in the same plane, that's why we are take the same sign convention. Now, the gear E is meshed with the gear D. Now, we have to calculate the relation between TC and TD. Therefore, we are knowing that TC, otherwise ND by NC is equal to ND is meshing with the D meshing with the E and NE meshing with the NC. So E will get cancelled. So we are getting ND by NC. So same things we are getting. So it is equal to TC by TD. So TC by TD we are getting, as it is the equal number of the teeth. So TC by TD is equal to 1. We are getting the ratio is equal to 1. That's why we are getting the 1. But this acts in the same plane. As the C rotates in the clockwise direction, D will rotates in the anticlockwise. Means the motion of the rotation of clockwise and anticlockwise are getting changed. As the C rotates in the anticlockwise direction, D will rotates in the clockwise direction. That's why we have to put the minus sign. So the next one, gear B is fixed, gear C rotates through the plus X revolution. So as the gear C makes the X revolution, just multiply with the X, C by T, and it is a minus X. Add Y revolution to each element, then total motion Y, X plus Y, Y plus X into TC by T, Y minus X. This is a table of the motion. Now we will see one example. So in this example, I will write down the given data. The pinion A on the propeller shaft has a 12 teeth. So the pinion A having the propeller shaft has a 12 teeth. So TA is equal to 12, and gears with the crown gear B having the 60 teeth. TB is equal to 60. The shaft P and Q of the rear axle which the rod wheel is attached. If the propeller shaft rotates at 1000 rpm, this propeller shaft is keyed to the gear A. That's why they are given a speed of the A is equal to 1000 rpm, and the rod wheel attached Q has speed of 210 rpm. This Q is attached to the gear D, so they are given as NQ is equal to ND is equal to 210 rpm. Find the speed of the P. So they had find out the speed of the P is nothing but the speed of the C. So they had asked find out the NP is equal to NC is equal to how much. They had asked this. So for that purpose, we have to formulate one table. So in that table, gear B is fixed. So the speed of the B is fixed. C makes the one rotation. That's why one. So E will makes TC by T as we have seen in the previous. And D will makes, this makes the plus one rotation, this will make the minus one rotation. So as the gear B is fixed, the gear C rotates through the plus one rotation. That's why 0x minus, sorry, here we are getting, it is rotated in the same plane. That's why plus x into TC by T, and here the minus x. Add Y rotation to each element, and here the total rotation. So this is a table of the motion. So just we have to check this condition. Under this given data, we have to find out the speed of the wheel, this wheel P. So right now they had given us the speed of the A. So A is meshing with the B. So we are knowing that an A by NB, it is inversely proportional to the number of the TB by TA. As NA we are knowing 1000 divided by NB is equal to number of the teeth on the B is 60 divided by TA is 12, so it is a 5. Therefore, NB is equal to 1000 by 5, 200. Therefore, NB we are getting 200 RPM. So, this is the speed of the wheel B. As this condition, the speed of the wheel B is Y. Therefore, we are getting Y is equal to 200 RPM. And the next thing they are given us, NQ is equal to ND is equal to 210 RPM. So here the speed of the D, Y minus X. Y minus X is equal to 210 RPM. As we are knowing the value of the Y is 200. 200 minus X is equal to 210. Therefore, 200 minus 210 is equal to X. Therefore, X is equal to minus 10 RPM. So this is the value of the X. Now they are asked find out the speed of the P or speed of the C. So speed of the C is equal to X plus Y. So speed of the C is equal to X plus Y. The value of X is minus 10 and the Y is 200. So we are getting the 190. So NC is equal to NP. So the speed of the P is equal to 190 RPM. This is the answer. This rotates. So by checking this equation, we are getting speed of the P means wheel is attached to the speed V is 190 RPM, and the Q speed as they are given us, that is a Q speed. So here Q speed is 210 RPM and NP we are getting the 190, means this rotates at 210 RPM. Simultaneously this wheel Q rotates 190 RPM in the same. So we are getting the difference in the speed of these two wheels. So I have taken these two references.